हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल क्वेस्ट फॉर नॉलेज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट वन मार्क्स, सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। द स्केर्स रिसोर्सेज ऑफ एन इकोनॉमी हैव कंपीटिंग यूसेजेस। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक स्टडी? इट इज कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर। सेंट्रल प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एन इकोनॉमी इंक्लूड्स ऑल द अबव। Traditionally, the subject matter of economics have been studied under the following broad branches, which is called microeconomics and macro. Why competing usages means we have limited resources and we have alternative uses. That is why it is competing. Okay, and we study micro, we study detailed study. So that is why consumer behavior will be the answer. Central problem, we study about what, how, whom to produce. So that is why all the above will be the answer. I hope you are clear with this MCQs of the first chapter. Now let's move on to the second. Utility is subjective. Okay, the shape of an indifference curve is always convex to the origin. Okay, and then the consumption bundles that are available to the consumer, it depends on the price and the income of the consumer. The equation of the budget line is product 1, quantity 1 is equal, and product 2, quantity 2 is equals to income. So that is why we need to write the equation P1X1 plus P2X2 is equals to M. The demand for this good increases as income increases, normal goods. And the demand for the good decreases as the income increases, is inferior good. A vertical demand curve is inelastic. So whatever be the change in the price, the demand will remain same. It has no effect on the change in price to change in demand. So that is why perfectly inelastic. Ordinal utility analysis expresses utility in rank. Okay, which is better, which is good, which is 5-star, which is 4-star, which is based on the ranks. It is called as ordinal utility. In cardinal, we express through the numbers. But in ordinal, we express through the rank. I hope you are clear with the second chapter, all the important MCQs. Let's start with the third chapter. So the first question is formula of production function means land and capital. So Q is equals to function of land and capital. Okay, we are taking only two products here. That is why land and capital. Q is equals to F, L and K. In the short run, a firm cannot vary all the input. In short run, a firm cannot vary. One remain fixed and some one remain variable. Okay, the change in output per unit of change in input is called marginal product. Okay, Coppola's production function is Q is equals to X1 alpha X2 beta. Okay, we need to understand the risk also, the return also. TC is equals to fixed cost plus variable cost, that is TFC plus TVC is equals to TC. The product in perfect competition are homogeneous, of same type of product, that is why it is homogeneous. The increase in total revenue for a unit increase in the output. So the same again question, if there is a little change in the total revenue because of a little change in the output, that is because of the marginal revenue. Okay, the firm's profit is donated by PIR. Okay, PIR is depicts the profit of the firm. When the supply curve is vertical, then the elasticity of the supply is zero. Yes, the same thing with the demand also we've written, the same thing with the supply. When the supply curve is vertical means it, the elasticity, there is no changes, there is no elasticity, the elasticity will be zero. The revenue per unit of output of a firm is called as our average revenue. Okay, per unit of output of a firm is average revenue. So we have completed the MCQ of the third chapter. Let's move on to the fourth chapter we have completed. Let's move on to the fifth chapter. In perfect competitions, buyers and sellers are price takers. Monopolists are the price makers, monopoly, but the rest of perfect competition, they are price takers. The situation where the plans of all consumers and firms in the market match, it is the equilibrium situation. Okay, when the supply meets to the demand. So when that is equilibrium situation. As a result of increase in the number of the firm, there is an increase in supply. Then supply curve will shift towards right. Okay, when there is increase, the supply curve will shift towards the right. When there is decrease, it will shift towards the left. The firm earns supernormal profit as long as the price is greater than the minimum of average cost. This is what you need to understand. So the firm will be earning supernormal profits. So the another question is, the government imposing upper limit on the price of goods and services is called price ceiling. The lower limit on the price is called as price flooring. Hope you are clear. So a market structure which produces heterogeneous means different level of product, variable product, it is monopolistic competition. The change in total revenue due to the sale of an additional unit, whenever the word comes additional, remember we need to write marginal. When the price elasticity of a demand is more than 1, MR has a positive value. Okay, because when the demand elasticity is more than 1, it means the marginal revenue is in the positive. Less than 1 means negative. Is equals to 1 means constant. Okay, profit is equals to total revenue minus total cost. By that we get the answer profit. The individual or institution which take economic decisions, jo bhi economic decisions are takers, are called as economic agents. In 1936, British economist J.M. Keynes published his celebrated book, General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money. All the laborers who are ready to work will find employment and all the factories will be working at the full capacity is a classical thought. The year of Great Depression is 1929. The capitalistic country production activities are mainly carried out by the private enterprises. So these all are the answers. These all we have completed according to the midterm examination syllabus wise. We have completed all the MCQs. Now we are going to discuss all the model papers and the previous year's question papers so that we should not take any chance and to score 5 out of 5. Let's get started with the model paper now. Central problem of an economy includes all the above. In perfect competition, buyers and sellers are price takers. They are not the price makers. Profit is total revenue minus total cost. In a capitalistic country, production activities are mainly carried out by the private enterprises. This is what we have discussed earlier, but this is important questions which may ask. It has been asked frequently and it might be asked in your examination as well. Traditionally, the subject matter of economics has been studied under the following broad branches. What is it? Micro and macroeconomics. The firms earn supernormal profit as long as the price is greater than the minimum of average cost is the answer. A market structure which produces heterogeneous products, it means variable products, is monopolistic competition. The year of Great Depression was 1929. So I hope you are clear. The scarce resources of an economy have competing usages. A situation where the plan of all consumers and firms in the market match is the equilibrium situation. The change in TR due to the sale of an additional means marginal. Okay, the individual or institution which take economic decisions are economic agents. So we have completed the model paper 2. Which of the following is an example of microeconomic study? It's consumer behavior. The government imposed a lower limit. It is price flooring. When the price elasticity of demand is more than 1, MR has a positive value. British economist J.M. Keynes published his celebrated book. It is General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money. The point, where the ex ante aggregate demand is equal with the ex ante aggregate supply is the equilibrium point. Okay, so this is all about. The scarce resources of an economy have competing usages. When the supply curve is vertical, elasticity of supply is equal to 0. Now you tell me the change in TR due to the sale of an additional unit, whenever the additional comes, what is the answer? The year of depression is 1929. Okay. Mm-hmm. The scarce resources of an economy have competing usages. The equation of the budget line is P1 X1 plus P2 X2 is equals to M, that is product 1 quantity 1 plus product 2 quantity 2 is equals to income. Cobb-Zola's production function is wherever the alpha beta comes, that is the answer, that is the Q is equal to X1 alpha XB B X2 beta. The individuals or institutions which take economic decisions are economic agents. So which of the following is an example of the microeconomic study? You answer me. The change in output per unit of a change in the input is called the change in output to the change in the input is marginal. Okay. Whenever the supply curve is vertical, that is elasticity is equals to supply. Wealth of Nation. So who wrote? J.M. Keynes has published a book which is the General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money. If you found the video helpful, do like, share and subscribe, and do hit the bell icon so that you will get all my latest notifications and updates, and I will be updating more of the videos which will be surely helpful for your coming economics midterm examination. So stay tuned and thank you so much for watching.